Echoes of Ethiopia, A Journey Through the Cradle of Civilization. Chapter 1. The Land of Legends. In the heart of the Horn of Africa, where the rugged Simien Mountains rise majestically against the sky and the ancient stone churches of Lalibela stand as testaments to a bygone era, lies a land steeped in history and tradition, Ethiopia. With its rich cultural heritage, breathtaking landscapes, and vibrant communities, Ethiopia beckons travelers to embark on a journey through the cradle of civilization. As the sun rises over the bustling streets of Addis Ababa, casting a golden glow over the colorful markets and bustling cafes, a young traveler named Yohannes stands at the edge of the city, gazing out at the sprawling metropolis before him. With a sense of anticipation and excitement stirring in his heart, he knows that his journey through Ethiopia has only just begun. From the ancient rock-hewn churches of Lalibela to the majestic castles of Gondar, Yohannes sets out to explore the diverse landscapes and cultural treasures of Ethiopia. He marvels at the towering obelisks of Aksum, ancient symbols of a once mighty empire, and he loses himself in the winding streets of Harar, where the scent of coffee fills the air and the sound of traditional music drifts through the narrow alleyways. But it's not just the ancient monuments that captivate Yohannes, it's the warmth and hospitality of the people he meets along the way. In the remote villages of the Omo Valley, he shares meals and stories with tribal elders, learning about their customs and traditions passed down through generations. And in the bustling markets of Bahir Dar, he haggles with merchants over colorful textiles and handcrafted souvenirs, each one a reflection of Ethiopia's rich cultural tapestry. Chapter 2. The Land of Contrasts. Leaving behind the ancient cities and bustling markets, Yohannes sets his sights on the diverse landscapes and natural wonders that abound in Ethiopia, the land of contrasts, where lush rainforests give way to arid deserts and towering mountains rise from the plains. In the remote wilderness of the Simien Mountains, Yohannes embarks on a trek through rugged terrain, encountering troops of gelada baboons and breathtaking vistas at every turn. He camps beneath the stars, the crisp mountain air filling his lungs as he gazes up at the Milky Way stretching across the night sky. And as the sun rises over the peaks, casting a golden hue over the landscape, he feels a sense of peace and serenity wash over him, a feeling of connection to the land and its ancient rhythms. But it's not just the mountains that captivate Yohannes, it's the hidden oases and tranquil sanctuaries that he discovers throughout Ethiopia. In the lush greenery of the Blue Nile Falls, he watches in awe as torrents of water cascade over rocky cliffs, creating rainbows in the mist. And in the otherworldly landscape of the Danakil Depression, he marvels at the surreal beauty of salt flats and volcanic craters, where geysers spew steam into the air and the ground glows with the heat of the earth below. Chapter 3. The Spirit of Resilience. Continuing his journey through Ethiopia, Yohannes finds himself drawn to the spirit of resilience and determination that defines the people of this ancient land, the spirit of resilience, where adversity is met with courage and hardship is overcome with grace. In the remote villages of the Tigray region, Yohannes meets farmers and herders who eke out a living from the harsh desert landscape, their faces weathered by sun and wind. He listens to their stories of drought and famine, of loss and hardship, but also of hope and resilience in the face of adversity. And he witnesses the transformative power of community as neighbors come together to support one another in times of need, sharing food, water, and shelter with those less fortunate. But it's not just the resilience of the people that moves Yohannes, it's the sense of unity and solidarity that he finds in Ethiopia's diverse communities. In the bustling streets of Addis Ababa, he joins protesters and activists calling for justice and equality, their voices rising in defiance against oppression and injustice. And in the quiet villages of the Amhara region, he witnesses the power of education and empowerment as girls and women are given the tools they need to build better futures for themselves and their families. As his journey through Ethiopia comes to an end, Yohannes reflects on the experiences and adventures that have shaped him along the way. From the ancient monuments to the natural wonders, from the resilient communities to the spirit of unity and solidarity, he has discovered the true essence of Ethiopia, the spirit of resilience, the beauty of diversity, and the strength of the human spirit. And as he watches the sun set over the horizon, casting its golden light over the land, Yohannes knows that his journey is far from over. With a heart full of memories and a soul filled with gratitude, he looks to the future, ready to continue exploring the wonders of Ethiopia and the world beyond. For in the echoes of Ethiopia, anything is possible, and the adventure is just beginning.